The River Realms, they call it. What a fine poetic name for something as rotten and twisted as our land has become. It was not always so. Long ago, the old empire, the noblest and most enduring society created by humankind, spanned almost the entire continent of Zerin, the cradle of man. But after several millennia of progress and incomparable achievements, inevitably, the empire began to fall into stagnation and decadence. Desperately holding on to their privileges and resisting change while trying to avert the collapse of the realm, the emperor and his theocracy took to measures that were worthy of true despots in cruelty. Subjugating weaker realms, enslaving whole nations, strip mining foreign resources, oppressing imperial citizens, war on several fronts, genocide. Eventually, the gods could no longer tolerate such horrors wrought in their name. Foretold by an abundance of divine omens, they descended upon the empire to right its wrongs. Thus, in a chain of dreadful events that became known as the Calamity, they annihilated the empire in a matter of days. The gods then finally saw what they had done in their anger and confusion. It is said that so much grief and shame filled them that they were broken and they left this reality, never to return. The continent and its inhabitants seemed dead, but at length survivors began to crawl out of their hiding holes and faced a land that no longer welcomed them. Arcane anomalies, the fallout of the calamity, now riddled the continent, and people realized that they had to share their new home with changed and twisted creatures. Terrible beings entered through the cracks in the tapestry of reality and rose to rule over the natives. In time, these new powers rebuilt the fallen empire in their own image, and the River Realms, now godless and vengeful, reincarnated from the ashes. The inhabitants of the land, such as I, now eke out a living under the crushing rule of the new empire. The continent itself constantly resists our every attempt at building a cozy home for ourselves. As travel is dangerous, many ventures specialize in transferring cargo and passengers over bleak and deadly leagues of land. Others try to take everything of value from said travelers, or attempt to find buried treasures among the ruins of the old empire. The leaders of the endeavors are, some say, the bravest men and women of the River Realms. Such a leader is called a Vargrus. Yes, a Vargrus. What a profession. Daring and savvy, always watching the horizon, always looking for an opportunity, and of course, for what is best for his comitatus, eh? And you are a Vargrus too, are you not? Many of your kind have I seen in my long life as a vagabond. Care to listen to a story about your exquisite occupation, good master? It is a tale of woe and terror. But it is also a tale that is true, as I have seen it with mine own eyes. Wise you are, good master. My tale is of a Vargrus, such as yourself, but one whose fate was cursed and wrought with ill fortune. It all happened a long time ago. 10 years, maybe more. I was but a passenger, travelling rough roads and forgotten ways with this comitatus, south along the feet of the great mountains of the west.
Thank you.